Hello friends, this is Dr. Mohammad Anees. Today, we are going to learn how to convert decimal to binary number. Let's start. These are few binary numbers with their corresponding decimal numbers. The very first thing we need to know is, what do you mean by integer and what do you mean by fraction? When a number is placed before decimal point, it is called integer, and when the number is placed after the decimal point, it is called as fraction. For converting the integer of decimal number to binary number, we have to divide the integer by base of binary number, that is 2, till we get the number that is indivisible by 2. In terms of fraction, we have to multiply the fraction of decimal number by base of binary number, that is 2, till we get 0 or the same fraction number. Let's convert this decimal number into binary number. When 15 is placed at this position, it is called as dividend. 2 is the divisor, which is the base of binary number. Here, 7 is the quotient and 1 is the remainder. 2 sevens are 14, 15 minus 14, we get 1, that is the remainder. Again, 7 should be divided by 2. 2, 3s are 6, again we get 1 as a remainder. 3 is again divisible by 2, so 2 ones are 2, again we get a remainder 1. Now, 1 is indivisible by 2, so for the last time we take, finally we get the remainder 1. Now we have to collect the remainder such that it represent the corresponding binary number of 15. So it should be collected from downwards to upward, where downward number indicates most significant bit and upper number indicates least significant bit. There is the final answer. The binary corresponding of decimal number 15 is 1111. Let's have a look on another problem. We have to convert 25 into its corresponding binary number. Let's start. 25. 12s are 24, we know that remainder is 1. 2 6s are 12, remainder is 0. 2 3s are 6, again remainder is 0. 2 1s are 2, remainder is 1. 2 1s are 2, remainder is 1. So we collect these remainders from downward to upward. Finally, we get 11001. This is the binary corresponding number of decimal number 25. Let's have a look on another problem. Here, we have to convert 14 into its corresponding binary number. 2 7s are 14, remainder is 0. 2 3s are 6, remainder is 1. 2 1s are 2, remainder is 1. 2 0s are 0, remainder is 1. As you know, we are going to collect it from downwards to upward. We get 1110. That is the binary corresponding number of decimal number 14. Let's have a look on another problem. Here we are going to convert 22. 2 1s are 2, 2 1s are 2, remainder is 0. 2 5s are 10, remainder is 1. 2 2s are 4, remainder is 1. 2 1s are 2, remainder is 0. And finally, 2 0s are 0, we get 1. So here we are going to, again we are going to collect it from downwards to upward. The binary corresponding number of 22 is 1110. Let's start solving the fraction numbers. Here we are going to calculate the corresponding binary number of fraction number 0.25. Pay attention, this is important. For converting the fraction number, we have to multiply the base of binary number with the fraction number of that particular decimal number, irrespective of the integer value. Whatever may be the integer value, we have to consider only the fraction number for multiplication with base of binary number. We get 0.25 into 2 is 0.50. Here you can see that we are taking only this fraction numbers for multiplication. 0.50 into 2 will give us 1. The fraction number we got is 00. Further multiplication with 0 will lead us to no number. That's why we are going to terminate the process of multiplication at this point. Now, for getting the binary number, we have to collect these integers, these integer values. How we have to collect? We have to collect it from upward to downward. Upward number indicates the most significant bit and lower number indicates the least significant bit. So the corresponding binary number of 0.25 is 0.01. Let's have another number, 0.75. So only the fraction numbers are taken for multiplication. 0.75 into 2 is equals to 1.50. 0.50 into 2 is equals to 1. Again, we got the 0. So we are going to terminate the process of multiplication and collect the integers. How we are going to collect? We are going to collect it from upside to downwards. So the corresponding number is 0.11. Let's convert 0.625. 0.625 into 2 is equals to 1.25. We are going to take the fraction numbers. 0.25 into 2, 0.50. 0.50 into 2, 1.00. The fraction numbers are 0.00. We are going to stop at this point and collect the integers. So the corresponding binary number is 0.101. Let's take a typical problem. Here we are going to convert 0.16. When 0.6 is multiplied, it gives us 0.32. Further multiplication gives us a series of numbers. So how we are going to decide at what point we have to stop? This is important. Pay attention. As soon we get the same fraction number, when the same fraction number is repeated, we have to stop at that point and collect the integers. So this is the corresponding binary number of 0.16. Let's take both integer and fraction together. First, we are going to convert the integer. 20, 2 tens are 20, 0, 2 fives are 10, remainder is 0, 2 twos are 4, remainder is 1, 2 ones are 2, remainder is 0, 2 zeros are 0, remainder is 1. We are going to collect it from downward to upward. For fraction, we are going to multiply 0.125 into 2, 0.25, 0.25 into 2, 0.50, 0.50 into 2, 1.00. At this point, as we got the fraction number 0, we are going to stop the process and collect the number. So the corresponding binary number of 20.125 is 10100.001. Important. For any odd decimal integer, the least significant bit of binary number must be 1. And for even decimal integer, the least significant bit of binary number must be 0. You should note this point. hope you got the clear idea of converting the decimal number into binary number. Thank you.